We are in Baudet, Minnesota. It's the northernmost part of the United States. We are right near the border of United States and Canada. We are here at AET, Automotive Enviro Testing Facility. They have a bunch of interesting snow and ice courses that we can test our traction control and performance on. They also have big cold chambers where we can fit our Class 8 trucks in. So we start our way from like negative 20, then we go to negative 30, and then eventually to negative 40, because we want to test the trucks at every cold temp barrier.
Basically, we have certain components, both mechanical and electrical, that are going to face different extreme temperatures through the life of the truck. And basically, we need to know how those components are going to respond to various temperatures. And basically, it's going to give us a good idea on when that component needs to have additional protection in order to protect the life of the product itself.
It ranges anywhere from negative 40 all the way up to 25, 27 degrees. And it's sunny outside, so it's pretty nice right now. This is a snow oval, so it's about 1.8 miles all the way through. And it's very well manicured, so we're able to hit a high speed, go into the corners at a high speed, be able to pack some snow into the truck so we can see how the components react, the high voltage components and low voltage components. And they also have some other tracks that are not as well manicured, so it's a little bit choppier and more bumpy to drive in. And they also have an ice sheet where you can take the truck on the ice sheet and see how the traction control works in the truck.
So we are trying to do some traction control testing on the ice VDA here. The reason we are doing this is we want to test out our regen settings and how traction works with like different regen settings that we have. So far, the traction's holding pretty good, and it's actually impressive, and like regen level 1 and 2 even more. So, I mean, yeah, so far the testing's going great, and traction control works pretty good.
It's being able to pick up to speed in no time, and get up to 68 miles per hour down the straightaway, and then just slightly touching it on the brakes on the corners and get into the corner and just and push the acceleration on the way out. So you're able to feel the full power of the axles, of the e-axles, just pushing this truck in the snow.
So far, it's doing really great. We are checking performance in like different operating modes that we have for our system, like the automatic drive mode, EV mode, and the manual charge mode. So we are testing performance in all of those operating modes. So we'll be wrapping up in the wash bay. So we'll pressure wash this this truck. Then maybe Ryan and Ty can help us, or Ben, you can help us check all the components if there's any water ingress in these components, since we have almost accumulated close to 100 miles today. And there's been a lot of snow inside those chillers.
The longer we spend time on track, the more chances we're going to have of getting snow, water, dirt, mud, and the components where we don't want it. And at the end of the day, we can disconnect these components after a wash to get an idea of if we have ingress in certain components, if we have problems with water running into either potted or sealed connectors. It's just going to give us a good idea of how sealed our system is. Check for any kind of coolant or fluid leaks, which is going to give us a good idea of if the junctions and everything we use is doing its job keeping all of the fluid in our system where it's supposed to be.
Hyliion to control, Hyliion to control.
And what does success look like when we leave here? What makes you happy?
The traction control performance, you don't even feel like you're driving on snow or ice surfaces. So it's definitely a big boost for us leaving from here like with some good performance and thermal management testing.
I love coming out here just for the simple fact that I can push this truck and see what it can do. And it's also very fun going high speed on these tracks and just pushing this kind of vehicle that is so heavy and so large. in this kind of terrain, it just makes it that much better as a driver.